Aries, how you doing? So we're here with your September. Wow, I haven't done a tarot card reading in a while. So how you doing, Aries? So just give me a second. So towards the end, you will see a couple of cards that appear in the bottom and the right-hand corner. If you want to follow those and click on those, that will take you to a description that will explain pretty much everything. So pretty much what I'm doing also on tier two, just very quickly, is the power of telekinesis and the things that we draw to ourselves when drawing the energy in. And what we realize is focus. We're focusing on our energy. So it's something that I'm teaching at the moment. A lot of people don't seem to realize the power that is held within focus. Okay, focus. So focusing our energy that draws the energy towards us. So obviously a lot of people tell you and they discover things about law of attraction, but what they miss is quite a few steps and something where I've unlocked Pandora's box. Literally the stuff that I have unlocked at the moment is each and even teaching me fucking loads of stuff, Aries. So let's have a go. So you might be wanting to go at having a go. So that is part of it as well. Someone's having a go at you, or you might be having a go at someone, or giving it a go. Okay, giving it one more go, or giving it a go. But giving it a go is something that I'm teaching at the moment, where we can go up to people in our lives with our energy and go, all right, do you want one more go then, Rush? Do you want one more go then, bruv? Come on then, let's have it, right? So, so that's something that I'm teaching at the moment. But let's see, Aries, Sun, Rising and Venus for September. Aries, Sun, Rising and Venus for September. All right, Rush, do you want another go? Oh, John, you got a new motor? Keep picking up John again. John. 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 Aries. You got a new motor? You got a new motor, Aries, or something? Or a new someone? Or you knew someone? Or he knew someone? John? I knew someone called John. Sorry. Aries, something rising of Venus. So, we're going to go with these. So, you've got the Two of Cups. The Two of Cups. The reflection of yourself. The reflection of your imperfection. Are you perfect? Are you imperfect? Do you know the hidden secrets in the realms of Pandora's box? And number two, the secrets of Pandora's box. The High Priestess of mirroring. Mirroring effect. The butterfly effect. The past. The past suddenly feels like, well, I'm Batman. I'm Superman. Well, I'm Clark Kent. Well, I'm Gladys Knight. Right? Night and day. Night and day. Night and day. Giving it a day. Well, giving it a day to believe. I'm a dream believer. Night and day. So, a day and night. Obviously, a night cycle of an eight is obviously, you've got two of them back to back. So, you've got eights. Okay. Sacrifice. 7 days of rest. After that was a reckoning of, there you go. There's the universe. What are you going to do with it? What is it that you're calling in? Telekinesis. What are you pulling towards you strongly? You're pulling something towards you strongly, Aries. Is it going to be a lesson of something? But you're definitely pulling someone towards you because you're pulling it towards the Two of Cups here, which is the Ten. So you've got the Eight and the Two, okay, which is the Ten. So you're pulling strength from a family member, or a family member is pulling strength for you, vice versa, either end of the scale. Some Aries might be the opposite end of the scale, and they're saying, no, it's my family that are strength for me, and some of you are going to be saying, no, it's me that's the strength for my family, okay? But the Ten of Cups. But some of you have come to an ending and a completion. An ending and a completion, where you've actually walked away. But you can't. So, sorry, Aries. You can't walk away from a family dynamic. Okay, probably if you've joined tier two, I can tell you many things that I've discovered, many things that help, trust me. But there are many rivers to cross. There are many points of breakdown. You could have had, someone could have had, there could be for some people where there is literally a Leo. This will be for some Moon, Rising and Venus, or someone out there. There's someone out there where there's a calling, okay? There's a call. Someone's going to call you, but there's a calling. Now, people think in life, yeah, my calling means that I'm a tarot card reader. My calling think, your calling, sorry, but your calling is what you're calling in, which is everything, which is everything. Now, me personally, okay, I've got a soul urge number of 8. So some of you could have that because you've got 2 8s, okay? Me, I'm a life path number 7, which is everybody, right? As we know, and a soul urge number of 8, okay? So we learn about that, but you've got 2 8s back to back. So urging, the soul is urged, there's an urge, but there's an approaching energy that fear and also aggression, fear and aggression of both. It's like, well, I know if I say something and I just push my button, if you just push my button, bruv, I'm out. But I've done this before. I've done it before and I've done it again. So what, are you a magician? What, are you an illusionist? Where have you gone now? Because you'll be back, right? Someone's got your back and someone's got your back up. Someone's got your back up because of something that they've said or that they've done. But if not, it's an energy that's felt through metaphysical where you're doing it on purpose to one another. A lot, some of you, your calling is to be seen. Generally, your calling is where some people just want to be seen. They just want to be seen. It's like the High Priestess. It's like a energy connection of telekinesis, but it's a show and tell. When you have a connection with someone, okay, and when you also do Skype calls and stuff that I do, but it's an energy exchange for an empath, an exchange. Trust me, there is so much stuff that when I'm exchanging a gift with someone and I'm telling them something, because I keep speaking and the channel is open, I channel through that person and through them and through you, exactly the same as this. Through you, through me, through you, through me, through you, through me. When you look at these cards, something is happening here where it's deafening. There's a calling where someone knows that it's getting someone's back up, but they just still having strength to keep doing it, even though no is a word. Yes is a word. Not maybe isn't like maybe. There might be a baby, maybe, right? There might even be a baby. But because of the answers of no, what you've got here is no, yes. Someone's confused, and that's why you've got, because you're fused. You're fused. Your energy is fused by being fused, by being triggered, by a response of a trigger and a reaction of a trigger. Someone's got their finger on the trigger of a reaction because they're connected. 2 8s. You're connected worldly. So you've also picked up a triggered response of probably a dark passenger that's keeping a response. So very connected. Now this could be anybody literally around you at all. Okay, so you've got delays, you've got Pisces and strength. So this can be in your chart, but somebody is wanting to walk away from a Leo to actually communicate with a Pisces in general. Okay, even if you've got that in your chart, someone's heading in your direction, or you're heading in their direction here, because you've got 3 8s, 3 8s back to back, 3 8s, 8 8 8, connected to spirit, connected to family, connected to everybody. There is a rock and a hard place for some people where someone could have Leo in their chart and you could also. But you could also have Pisces in your chart, but you could also be connected with a Pisces for a lot of you. You've got family dynamics going on that you want to walk away from, and you're stuck at home of someone that's got your backup at home, or they've got your backup or you've got their backup. Or there's a backup or a pickup truck. Someone's trying to get picked up. Someone's, whoa. Someone's after a pick-me-up, meaning there's some attention that's needed. Someone's crying. This is the cry. Okay, something that I've also wrote. Be careful on the energy that you put out because the universe can hear you cry. So, one, can you cry at all? Two, if you do cry, how are you filling up these cups? Why is it that you constantly need rebuilding, remodeling. There's a modeling contract for some people. But why is it that these stale cups constantly need replenishing, but you're doing it the wrong way? You're doing it the wrong way. You've walked away, but you go back. You walk away and then you go back. You walk away and then you go back. Now, this can be to the person, but even if it's not the physical person, it's the mindset that's being pulled back this way towards the Two of Cups, because you've got a soulmate relationship going on. You've got the push and pull effect, the mirror effect. Shall I stay? Shall I go? Shall I stay? Shall I go? Connected to them, definitely, 100%. Some of you have got a strong connection with a Pisces, but you're being triggered. These are the triggers. These are the things that happen with mirrors, because you trigger yourself off. But if you don't know how to deal with triggers, trust me, honestly, and I'm not trying to just get people, right, get backs up, is to literally, that's why I offer Skype calls. And also tier two, because there is some stuff that is coming out of my Pandora's box, out of my, I'm a Pisces as well, right? This energy, and also Soul Edge 8, that is really, really connecting, okay? To a lot of hidden stuff. There's hidden desires for people here, but you're experiencing a mirror, the mirror effect. Which is like, poof, all of a sudden, phew, oh my God, you're there again. It's like magic, right? Magic. Oh, 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 it's magic, you know. You know what I call in my soul. You got a call in your soul. You've got coal in your soul. Someone's got a lump of coal in their soul. Sorry, a lump of coal in someone's soul, where it's like burnt out. You're burnt out. Someone's burnt out, you see. Hard drive. Your hard drive literally probably is burnt out with the amount of work you're doing. Right? But also, your hard drive, of what I explained in the card. Cups need replenishing the right way. They need emptying the right way. Vocabulary. Very important. I can teach you that way. Honestly. But... and I do not fool around when it comes to energy. I do not, trust me, because it's a lot to do with energy and people's meat suit that people are missing. It's a lot to do with pride. It is. It really is. And this person could be too prideful to actually admit anything, where you're in a mirror effect of like, well, I want you and then I don't. And then I want you and then I don't. And then I'm confused. Do you want me? Do I not want you? Who wants who? Well, who loves you and who do you love? The running man. You've got Arnold Schwarzenegger as the running man. You've got the running man trying to escape. You're trying to escape the prison of Jaws. The prison of Jaws. Someone could have a headache. Someone could have a headache by the amount of stuff that they had to go through. Show me the way to go home, boom, 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 tired and I want to go to bed. I had a little drink about an hour ago and it's gone right to my head. Wherever I may roam, land or sea or foam, you will always hear me singing this song. Show me the way to go home, boom, boom, boom. Right. Show me the way to go home, Steve. Tell me, how do I get home? How do I find my calling? How? Some of you could be sending smoke signals or doing stuff with smoke, or vaping, or trying to give up, or you're vaping, or smoke, or you've got a smock. What do you know? It might be one of these. But you could have a smock, but or a moccasin, but smoke. Someone's like, poof, oh shit. Oh shit, it actually came true. They did come back. But now what do I do? Sorry. But they got my back up and I didn't realise that I'd manifested them back into my life. Again, process that I'm teaching people. Okay? Poof. Why the fuck did they come back when I tried so hard to get rid of them, but I'm missing the main ingredient. Now, some of you, you might be indulging ingredients. Who knows? Who knows, right? But I'm saying it, so some of you are literally missing the main ingredient. And that ain't nothing, no dibble dabble. It ain't no magic. It's purity. That's what I will teach. I'm teaching people. And I do not want people to honestly miss out. I've left it as cheap as possible. But the stuff that I'm going to be adding also is very, very deep. Deep. But someone's got deep wounding of their communication. It's like they're communicating, but it's like they communicate and then they walk away. It's like they do something within the metaphysical realm of something that's giving them that urge to just be seen and heard. They want to be seen and heard. Now, that don't have to be a bad thing, but someone is being seen and someone's being heard, but there's a recovery. Someone could be driving a discovery. They're on, obviously, a discovery. They might even be on the Discovery Channel. There's a song there. Oh, dear, that was to do with sex and drama, wasn't it? The animal... yeah, we'll leave that one. Someone's got animal instincts. Instincts. It's like... They just sniff out, like, this scent. It's like they've got a scent. And it's like, I've got you on my radar. I've got your backup. And I know I've got your backup. And I know you're going to walk away, but I know you're going to be back. Sorry, Aries. But it's like... Someone's giving their power over willingly. You see, they're giving their power over. You're giving too much power over to this person that's trying to draw the strength back. This is the mirror. You're pulling away, but you're pulling away probably for some in the wrong manner if you're going for a dynamic because you're being pulled backwards. It's like, what you're doing is thinking, some of you could be thinking, oh my God, they're so powerful. They're so powerful. And you're thinking it and you're going through it in your mind and your mind. Well, what's your mind's eye telling you? What's your mind's eye pulling towards you? Right? Is it them or is it you? Or are you fucking lost in a mirror already? You know, because I can see my way out of it. Well, I could for you. Some people... Because generally a lot of normal tarot card readers will say, this is a really good reading. You've got the Two of Cups with a Leo and it's great. And you're communicating. But I don't pick it up that way at all. Someone is really connected. But what you're pulling in is 8 here, regardless. Now, trust me, if you've got a life path number 7 and a soul urge number 8, or even if you've got a soul urge number 8, what it talks about is... power, everything. Everybody say they're the most two powerfulest numbers out, I think, 7 and 8. But that's not, that does not mean that takes a lot of learning, a hell of a lot of learning, because you have to learn to receive energy, a receiving energy, to pull the energy in, to receive it, okay, to receive it, because you've got polar opposites. You've got a giver, of what we give out, but what we learn to receive. And that's where the mirror's coming from. Someone's trying to receive too much because some people are receiving a lot of information. So that can be good because this will still represent wisdom. But it can also represent delays in travel and delays in communication. And very, very like, whoa, the fuck is... I've been going through this for so long and I am so attracted or so attractive or so attracted to this person, but it's driving me nuts because some people have got a metaphysical connection with one or two people, one, but some people have got connections also with others too. So it would relate obviously to Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus because you've got 3 8s back to back, man. 3 8s, that's connected to the world wide web, but also to the world wide web of where you're being seen and heard, right? So for some of you, you feel it, but you're also fearing it, but you're loathing it, and fear and loathing in Las Vegas, but you're also seeking protection against someone, but you can't figure out why, or they can't, but probably you both can't, or you can, but you're still confused. It's a fused, someone's fusing you, someone's fusing your energy, but you're fusing it yourself, you're fusing yourself. If you're in this predicament where you're drained, seek out an all-seeing eye and a seeker, okay? A seeker. Because this is a lot of clairvoyancy also, a lot of clairvoyancy. A lot of interconnections, intergalactic space where you just, like, you deal with metaphysics and quantum physics and law. But water, fire, earth, air, elements. Elemental, dear Watson. Elemental, dear Watson. You've figured it out. Someone's got a nice figure. But this is like, there's a lot of guidance, obviously. But trust me, all guides need a guide. Even if you're a guide and you're a tarot card reader and you're a guide, some people still need guidance because they can't hear it. Sometimes, okay, there's so much going on that realizing if you're just on your journey, how much you're connected to spirit, it's vital for first steps, especially as a child. It might be a child, because I'll pick that up, okay? Of firstborn steps. Some of you could be pregnant or had a firstborn, but reborn, but born again, awakening. Okay, fused, born again, awakening from your first to your seventh house. So when I teach people with this plate, okay, here, first house, here. One in six, here. One in seven, here. Okay, so we go over that. Sorry, I don't know why I'm shouting at people. This could be someone that's shouting or screaming or shouting, or you're just fearing. It's like, there's just so much in my head. I feel like I'm going to explode. Let's see one more card for Aries for September. But obviously the clarifying cards will tell me more about what this is. Oh dear. So it could well be to do with a child, okay, a child, but a child that is trying to discover something. Some of you could have a child that's trying to discover something, and they're very interested in homework, or they're trying to find out information. But someone's trying to find out information and understand what this is that's keeping them blocked. Some people could have, like, an earth sign child, and it'd be an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and they're studying probably about this, maybe for some of you, okay? Or it could be the elemental child, which is really not a mental child. They're not mental. Trust me, they're not. If you're going through that, your children are not mental. If they're going through a spiritual awakening, they are on a discovery. If it's you, you're also on a discovery. You could have children that are, and you are also. You're all on a path and a journey, a very connected one, worldly. So that would mean with everybody that's in your soul group. These are all soul group people. It's like judgment, that's what I said. Eight is the day of the awakening, the day the bugle cried to say that there are eight suns, and the seventh day of rest is now over, and you now have a chance with the universe. It's yours. You can hold that power within your hand. You know, so there's a lot to obviously discover, right? Discover. So, for some of you, there's a Pisces that's in between a family dynamic or an actual dynamic where you have got, or they don't want anything to do with anybody or a person. That you could have Pisces in your chart, or it could be anybody, but the communication could be very childlike, or you're just not on the same wavelength. You're just not on the same wavelength. Some of you, you can be, but it depends where it's in their chart. But this would be where you're trying to block something out. There's somebody that's trying to, there's, like I said, there's some people that are trying to study and learn. Now, because I am a Pisces, it could be just as simple as something like, you're all just sitting here watching me now, right? That can be something simple like that. But if you're looking at this as a dynamic, this person here could be a family dynamic. Because you go from a 2 to an 8, back to the start of 4, which is here, which is 5. 6. Six of Cups, which is 14, which is 5. So working on building on university, working and building on learning about work and learning about what it is that people want to do as a career. And it might be the children that are learning what it is that they really want to do in life, okay? Because they're on a journey and they're just discovering what it is that they really want to do. They've got a desire, they've got an idea that's planted. This is plant them, they will grow, watch them waver so. And here we go, on a discovery. But you've got the Six of Cups, where it's all to do with family and children, and it's all to do with a complete dynamic of where some people have like a Five of Cups, where they're turned around. They've turned around. Some people have turned around and faced away. Could be a Leo that's faced away. And that a Leo, for some of you, in that Five of Cups, is why you really need to replenish your cups properly. Okay, there's the Five of Cups that I'm going to do a video on. It will be explaining in depth of the Five of Cups, why it's a fucking great card, why it's a brilliant card. Because we turn it the other way around. We turn around to face ourselves, to face our fears, to face anxiety, to face panic, to face worry. We stare this energy of strength right in the eyes. Okay? Somebody is staring at a Leo, or watching a Leo, or a Leo is watching you right in the eyes. It's like the devil. It's the counterpart, really, to strength. But You're losing strength because you've got this mirror. You've got this family dynamic that is awakening you. A lot of you are going for a deep cleansing soulmate journey, but also a family dynamic, but also a spiritual journey, where some of you might be well on the verge of thinking that you might need an extraterrestrial to tell you that you're actually human. Right? Someone from out of space that can read space, right? The space between time and existence. The space between time and existence. Separate oneself away from so much power that can be learned. The space-time continuum continues. This, in that way, a lot of you might be like, oh, fuck. But some of you could be like, fuck, but yes. You know? Because I'm in denial. I really want them, but I don't want them. But I do, but I just, they're just so, you know, elemental or mental. Some of you, I'm just so mental over this person. They drive me fucking nuts, but the fuck is it? What is it about you that's mysterious? Mysterious girl, I want to be close to you. Mysterious. The mystery of history, right? But why is history a mystery? Can you change it? Can you cry? Can you cry in the right manner? Someone's trying to learn to cry. Some people are crying. But some people are crying for attention. But like I said, be careful of the attention that you cry for, because spirit hears every cry that you have. Every cry that you have. That's why we talk about telekinesis in tier two. Mutable and moving objects, but not in the way you think. Like, come to me, speaker. Spoon bending. But button moon. We're off to button moon. Someone's got your button. Someone likes to, sorry, tweak your button. For some of you. Oh dear. Sorry, Dave, stop it. Look, Dave is my spirit guide. If you don't know me, my spirit guide's called Dave. Someone's a tweaker. Someone's tweaking you. They're like, oh. Sorry. Someone's giving you like a an orgasm, but like a tweaking energy of like, oh my God, I can, oh. Convulsions. I can feel this metaphysical connection that some of you have got. Now, this a lot for some of you can be a brand new person that you've just met. And you think that they're Batman or Superman, that they can literally save you. And if it's a new connection or if it's a new teaching thing, more than likely. Because they're going to give you a brand new idea that will set you free. It'll set you free. They'll give you a brand new idea that will set you free. This idea will set you free. So, like I said, so what we're going to do is we're going to clarify all of these cards, and that will tell me the whole picture. I'll continue to channel and we'll pull all the cards to see exactly what this is about. This is for your September, guys. This is for your September. So I've got a few projects running. The cards will start to appear towards the end, so you can click on them. That will tell you a lot about stuff. The link below to Patreon gives you the same video that you can just watch, and it tells you what I offer as a Skype consultation, or actually literally what I teach in tier two, okay? But everything can hopefully be found in all the descriptions. But this will also be over on your Vimeo monthly, in your monthly folder for September. It'll be in the monthly folder for Vimeo. If not, still tier one, still tier two. But the teaching stuff gives you access to tier one and tier two, okay? So let's clarify these up and clear it up, clear up the matter, and see what the, oh dear, what can the matter be? And you will find out if you join tier two. Okay, so we'll see you again soon. Thanks, Aries. Bye.